Computer is made by human. Software made is by human. If we do mistakes, there's always a human involvement. There's one luxury in life that we can never, never, never be able to replace. It's time. My name is Sevan Istanboulian. I was born in Lebanon, 3rd September 1967. Since 1984-85, I adopted Montreal as my living city. Friendship, loyalty, and living life. Having my daughter. Living an impact on somebody else's life positively. Being able to go back to a happy family. When you travel so much, you see a lot of good things, you see a lot of misery. There's so much you can do and you can't help everybody. When you come back to reality, first you appreciate what you have. Second, you make sure to just live your life to the fullest. Be nice, go home, because if you're not feeling to do your job, you're not feeling good at what you're doing, feeling part of what is around you, well, maybe that day you should take a break. And I do that too sometimes. I don't show up to work because I will never be productive. Actually, it would create more mess. 4 hours, project after project, I need to be on the run constantly. I rather spend one day without coffee than spending a day with bad coffee. We visited Dominican Republic. We went into the mountains. There was an industry of cigar wrapping, hand roasting on the side. The smell of the roasting is great. It attracts me because where I grew up, there was a roastery not too far from the house. The smell of it is just beautiful. And it just brought me back childhood memories, and I stopped, understood how the coffee was. The friend of mine who approached me with the idea of his to start specialty coffee roasting cafe, it was no questions. There's good to be done here. The only mistake I did, I was too young and stupid. I didn't take a deeper look at his business plan. But when it comes to running a business, you roll up your sleeves. If it needs to be clean the toilet, you do it. I got acquainted with David Griswold and Sustainable Harvest. He invited me, was organizing a trip to Costa Rica at the research center of CATI. I was there with people from Pete's, from Allegro, medium-sized small companies. And that's where the kind of Let's Talk Coffee was born. On the business side, my grandfather, I never seen him sign a contract, but he used to run a multi-million leather company. On the espresso side, the way that Paolo Dalla Corte simplifies things in life, there's no second. We're always striving to discover better. We're always striving to do better. We're always striving to appreciate certain realities. This is as good as it can get, but yet, you can't say that coffee cannot surprise you. Eastern Africa is the best green coffee spot for me. Natural wealth, natural possibilities. The potential of Africa is unbelievable based on green coffee or other culture products. But I should say also Africans have to start acting like Africans. It was perfectly functioning tribal way before colonialism. There's no reason it can't function now. Do you like coffee? I don't like the bitterness. I didn't ask you if you like or you didn't like bitterness. I asked you what you like. Almost no coffee is well processed and well brewed. Bitterness is part of it, but sweetness should take over. The acidity of coffee turns into sweetness. The chocolatey aftertaste that resembles the bitterness, it's always present. So it's a balanced, complex product, and it should be treated like that. Coffee behaves for me as a challenge. Every time it plays tricks on you and it keeps you on your toes. When we had a coffee, we weren't sure whether to define it in ferment or winey. Let's wait, because about 80% of the time people drink specially filter brew at room temperature. And after cooling down, absolutely turned around and became nice, winey, unbelievable taste. So you always have to give time and really make sure that it relieves itself. It's like a human nature. You have no way to know how it's going to end. Now looking back, a lot of times I laugh and I say, my God, either all my customers were stupid or very, very, very lucky. Because if I did all those mistakes now, I wouldn't even have my own coffee in my own coffee machine. We're at a point where the consumer is much better informed, all kinds of websites, which brings in their own dilemma because you read some stuff and you're not even sure how true or how bad or how good it is, but it becomes a reference. That's one of the reasons I got involved into the SCA's Roasters Guild. It became a complete, huge educational tool today. I saw the Hawaiian coffee poster with a genie coming out of the pot. Marcella got it. It was what? It was going to be called Mystique Coffee. Mystique in French, coffee in English. Perfectly bilingual for Canada, and the world can understand it too. This is not far away from the romantic view of coffee roasting. Every human has its own signature. When you're hand roasting, this is going too fast, to slow it down. Or it's going too slow, speed it up, do this, change the speed of fan. Take a look at your drum speed. So we found a way to develop softwares, time, temperature, up or down. How fast or how slow? Well, if we can feed all that to a computer, mimic it better than a human. The computer doesn't have any mood swings. It could repeat based on only coffee's behavior. We went back to have Tiptronic so we can bring in that charm of manual interaction whenever we like. The system manages all the security around it, and that's where it becomes dynamic roasting profiling. One thing with family business is that there's no, I don't have time. The business becomes part of you. The barista scene in the specialty market in the US, Canada, it's good and it's bad. Open to try, but that in order to be different, you have to be eccentric. We do have a ton of shades of brown. Each of them will give you a different perspective of taste. And after you taste all of them, then decide which one you want to offer to your customer and understand if that is what the consumer wants or not. It's a mirror image. Simplicity, accuracy, repeatability. It's an honest machine. It never lets you down. You should get what you pay for. But Paolo, you do get and more. If the barista is too busy, taking the shot glass, taking a look at the timer, spending about half a pound of coffee, trying to adjust the grinder, not being able to concentrate on communicating his effort, transforming it to taste, I'm not sure if he's really doing good to anybody. So you need to have a tool, a system, that can repeat what the barista would have done. When you give that time to a barista to interact, that customer will remember the moment and come back. Mystique. The $3 billion question. If we keep destroying environment the way we are, coffee will be one of the first victims. If I have the chance, a second chance in life, I will start the same thing all over again, just more precise. Live life, there's no tomorrow. Because in this world today, you have no clue what every second could or would bring. But living life, it means enjoying life with friends, with people around you, with people that they like you and they dislike you, because it's your choice, not theirs. But at the end of the day, say, you know what, I did good today. Ha 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 ha